So it ain't gonna matter. You know what I mean? I went to college on the, with the desire to be a lawyer. Got an English degree because I wanted to go to law school. Right. So I saw myself growing up as being in a professional environment. Right. But I work at UPS, which is, I love my job. Don't get me wrong. Well, I like what I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? Don't get me wrong. As far as, you know, the capacity as a supervisor, I like being in a leadership position.
Right.
So I like the leadership aspects of my job. Let me say it like that. But I don't wear a suit and tie to work. I don't wear a shirt and tie. I don't wear a suit. So looking at him, what I came to realize what was going on in that moment is he is what I wanted for myself. That image of him is the image that I wanted for myself. Mm-hmm. Right? Because I guarantee, hey, he had on a jumpsuit that said Georgia State of Corrections on the back, I wouldn't have been bloated.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I don't have that desire for myself. You know what I mean? But he's what I saw for myself. And I had to tear him down and some, like, it couldn't have been true. Because if it was true, for some reason, it made me feel inadequate. You know, it had nothing to do with me. Like, it had nothing to do with me, bro. You know what I mean? Yeah. The truthfulness of the picture, any of that don't matter. That's all irrelevant. Right?
Right.
The truth of the matter is that's what was there. And just for the simple fact that there's a possibility that can be true, why can't I be happy for bro?
Yeah.
Like, why can't I be happy for bro?
Mm-hmm.
If that's his time and that's how he saw himself and he's achieved what he considers as a milestone, why can't I be happy for that?
Mm-hmm.
Right? The truth is, I'm not happy for that because I'm not happy with something in myself.
Right.
And that's what it really was. Yeah. Right? And,
You felt like you're lacking.
So I felt like I was lacking in some area.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And is it true that because I don't wear a certain title to work that I'm lacking in some area? Nah, because I'm sure that I make, as far as if we're talking about from a financial aspect, I make more money than people who wear a shirt. Like, you wear a shirt and tie to Progressive.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And that's nothing against somebody at Progressive, you know what I'm saying? Not trying to throw anything like that out there. But shirt and tie does not indicate the intensity or the. It doesn't it really indicate anything about your job.
Yes.
Right?
It's dressed over.
Yeah. Like, so, that would be my example.
Yeah.
Right? As far as. Just in times where I catch that about myself. And what we're talking about is very natural, but nobody wants to be labeled as a hater.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Because, you know, we got all that, you know, make your haters your motivators. Stop hating, salt me up. Just all of these different mantras about, basically about tearing people down or talking about people or whatever it may be. But the truth is, a lot of people say the mantras and they do all this bull job, but they're not even aware that they hate. Right, they have the same thoughts, emotions, feelings that we're sharing on the podcast. The difference is we're actually aware of it first and foremost, and then we're also honest enough to say, "Yeah, I be hating."
Yeah.
Like, even though now I'm aware of it and I catch myself and I redirect my thoughts, it's still hate in my heart.
Right.
Like, I know it's in the I be feeling it. You know what I mean? So, I think all three examples were very relevant.
Yeah.
And relevant in the sense that a lot of people could relate with them from a relational aspect, especially single people looking at married people wanting what they got, and then vice versa, married people looking at single people wanting what they got. Because I got some single partners that call me to this day and tell me about their Saturday night, and I'd be like, like, boy, you did all that?
Yeah.
Like, man, that's exciting. You know what I mean? Right, well,
and you also had those single friends who would be like, "Hey man, what I gotta do to get what you got?"
Exactly, that's what I'm saying. You know,
like, "Dang man, I see y'all doing this, I see y'all doing that."
Yeah,
what I gotta do to get that?
Everybody chasing what the other man got, man.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing about the grass being green on the other side, like when you get over there, you still gotta water it, cut it, fertilize it. Like, you still got to take care of the grass, or it's going to look just like the grass that you had on the other side.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It ain't about what side you're on. It's about what you do to the grass.
Yeah, that's it.
You know what I mean? It's about what you put into it. You know what I mean? You're going to get out what you put into it, no matter what your situation is.
Yeah, yeah.
But man, the detriment of quote unquote, and I guess hating just gonna be the term that we gonna go with.
Yeah.
Right? But what's the detriment of tearing somebody down? Like, is it okay to do that? Is there any consequence for doing that? And I go ahead and tell you, you know, you look at many spiritual texts and it says, you know, things like, love thy neighbor as you love yourself.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And one thing about it, if you're doing that to somebody, like what I said earlier, it's a deficiency in yourself. You actually are portraying a lack of love for yourself. Mm-hmm. Right? Really, any kind of judgment of anybody is portraying a lack of judgment in yourself. I mean, a lack of love in yourself. Mm-hmm. Because if God said, let us make man in our own image, and that is a man, that man has God in him. Right? Is the same God as in you is the God as in him. Now, if his choice of expression of that God is not what you desire, it don't matter. You know what I mean? It's still his God element in him that he is expressing.
Right.
So the love thing has to be universal, man.
Yeah.
Right? And you can't see people for what they're doing, man. You really got to see people for who they are. Right? At the end of the day, that is a human being with the same powers and same abilities as you. Right? Like, no matter what they're portraying at the moment, you have to be wise enough and mindful enough to speak about people for who they are, even if they don't know who they are.
Right?
Right? You still have to speak of them in that way. So, in your opinion, is there a detriment, or is there anything negative that can, for yourself, right? Is there a negative aspect on it for yourself, for you talking negatively about somebody else, or you thinking negatively about somebody else? How does that come back on you?
Yeah, most definitely, man. That just plays along with me. That goes with that secret that everybody be talking about.
What's that?
You know what I'm saying? You, what you think is what you receive.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying?
Go ahead and work that, man.
Yeah, that, you know, that law of attraction. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So if, like you say, I look on the social media and I see this man, it's like, dang, like you said, man, I want to be, why that's not me with this suit and tie on, this briefcase, you know what I'm saying, with my own office.
And you go to tear him down.
Yeah, man, like, you know what I'm saying, he don't deserve that, you know what I'm saying, he ain't did this, he ain't did that, I done did all this, and you know what I'm saying, went to school for, you know what I'm saying, 3-4 years, and all this, man, I want that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying, but that negative energy, like you say, that hate, that tear down, you, like you said, that's what you looking at, that's what you want. Mm-hmm. So you looking in the mirror, basically just tearing down yourself.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that's just gonna trickle down, and that's gonna lead to stress. That's gonna lead to more worries. Like, dang, now, you know what I'm saying? You really worried about what you gotta do to get to this spot.
Now you know you're covered.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You stress. You worried about this. You even cause you to be angry at times. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Just with people who, for no reason. You know what I'm saying? You mad at the wrong people. Just causing strife in different relationships that you in. You know what I'm saying? It has an effect on everywhere you go. And that goes back to the seeds you plant. That's what you go, when they start growing, that's what's gonna grow. Mm-hmm. Those flowers those seeds of envy and stress and all of that other stuff. So, I mean, you, like you say, you just got to be mindful, because that law of attraction is real. What you think, what you put out, is what you're going to get back in.
What you think about that, Jarvis? You agree with Trial?
Yeah, man, 1,000% I agree with him. That law of attraction, pretty much that thought that you put out, that energy that you put out, the man above hears that, feels that, see that, and he's not going to bless you. I wrote down a Bible verse. You brought up a Bible verse. I wrote that down earlier. Proverbs 14:30 says, a sound heart is life to the body, but envy is the rottenness to the bones. So yeah, it's like real detrimental. Like both of y'all said, it's real detrimental, because you're not gonna grow from that.
And that verse literally says, like Travis said, as far as unhealthy, it literally says body and bones.
Yeah.
Like literally, like it's gonna fit you physically.
Right.
it will manifest in your body.
Yeah.
Right.
And like you said, heart, man, it's the love, man. And Like I said, you're not gonna go for that. Like, for example, like what I said about my relationships. Like, even though I like her a lot, I wish her nothing but the best. But like, still, sometimes I have ill will feelings about that. And God ain't gonna bless me for what I want in the future.
Is He not gonna bless you because you had the feelings, or because you allowed the feelings to persist?
I allowed the feelings to persist.
Okay. I don't want to confuse anybody, because to actually have the feeling, you don't have control over. Like, for the feeling to pop up, it's not your control. It's what you do. Yeah. First of all, are you aware of it?
Right.
And then what do you do with that awareness? Like, do you take that awareness and be like, yeah, that's exactly how I feel. You know what I'm saying? Or do you take that awareness and you, hey man, listen, can't no happiness come outside of myself. I'm doing myself a disservice thinking about this like this. I'd rather just let it play out. I wish them the best, and I'm thankful for what's going to happen for me. Right. So I'm sorry to cut you off, but I always want to clear that up, because I don't want people thinking that this is a mind control type thing.
Because
it ain't like, this ain't no positive thinking, mind control type thing. This is strictly about awareness.
Right.
Mindfulness and awareness. So...
But yeah, like you said, God sees that He's not gonna bless me like that. And I feel like this is the whole hating thing, is like, what you hate about is really, majority of the time, is not really the point. And we just gotta look at that, be aware of that too. Like you said, I can bring another example, somebody's job. Like, you hate on somebody's job, like me, I bring up my instance by myself. I'm job searching, so I see somebody, like, I had class, and I'm like, man, this joke ain't never do work. He copy off of me, like, you feel me? Like, he's asleep in class, and he just BS through college, like, how he got a job he got, and I'm still job searching. So it's like, just different instances I was bringing up. It's like,
I bet people think that about me.
A lot of people think that way.
I got locked up 4 times in college. You know what I mean? Yeah. I'm supervising all kind of folks.
Yeah.
So if anybody ever go back and check the resume and pull up a few mug shots, they would be like, what? Yeah, you know what I'm saying? But there's other parts of me that they don't know.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Just like my man. I ain't had a real conversation with him in probably a decade. He probably got another element that I don't know. He probably got a way of thinking that I don't know, that allows good things to happen for him. Maybe as an only child, he expect good things to happen for him.
Yeah.
Therefore, he gets good things. You know what I mean? So, who am I?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And the Bible also says that as you judge, you will be judged.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Like, you will be judged to the same fervor that you judge others. Right? Mm-hmm. So, all of these opinions and perceptions and all that you have about people, man, like, bro, grill them job and eat them. Yeah. All that beef that you got with people,
hating on this family because this person, because they got this, because they got that, man. Like they always say, man, we all got the same 24 hours in a day.
Yeah, man. Mm-hmm. And like you said, Trav, as far as like thoughts expand, man. Yeah. So what you think that you're thinking for somebody else, just like the Bible says, judge. Like, you're going to be judged the same way. You really thinking it for yourself.
Yeah, so when you on Facebook and you looking at the picture and you talking, and where it's bouncing off that screen and coming right back.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The person on the other side ain't catching that.
Yeah. So why wouldn't you, if you know that your thoughts are creative, your words are creative, and what you put out there is what you're going to receive, why wouldn't you talk about it in love?
Yeah.
Like, oh, man, that's a beautiful relationship. Boy, I like that, boy. Yeah. 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 You know what I'm saying? Oh, man, that's a nice trip. Oh, Jamaica? Yeah, boy. Hey, little sunny out there. You know, I like that. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they got that Merrow. I do like that Merrow. You know what I'm saying? I'm a Bentley Coupe type of man.
Yeah.
And I ain't seen nobody on the timeline yet in a Bentley Coupe. So I'm still good right now. You know, I ain't had no challenge on that end yet, man. But Chad, when we riding, you know, I'm building a house out in Guyton.
Right.
And right now I'm building a house in the neighborhood, but what I really desire is a house off on the side, outside of the neighborhood on my own land.
Right.
Those big estates that you see that have all the grass in the front and the house is way back and has the fence around. Mm-hmm. When I ride by, I don't ride by with hate. I ride by with oh man, I'm glad I live on this street so I can see that every day.
Yeah.
It's like motivation, like, man, that's a nice house. Like, man, that's nice, you know what I'm saying? And that's how you should celebrate people's stuff, man. Because for something to happen for somebody else should let you know that it's possible for yourself.
Right.
Right? So how is that a bad thing? Like, to see somebody in Jamaica on your timeline lets you know that Jamaica is possible.
Yeah.
Right? To see bruh in a suit and tie lets me know that a suit and tie is possible. To see the house and the marrow and the whatever it may be, it's just an indication that it's possible. Right? It's just another example that what I desire is actually possible. Why wouldn't you thank that person for that?
Yeah.
Like, oh man, thank you for showing me the path once again.
Yeah.
Thank you for showing me that it's possible once again. Man, you gotta cultivate a heart of thankfulness, man. You gotta cultivate a heart of love. And you have to do it moment by moment. To cultivate anything is moment by moment. Yeah. Like the farmer don't skip a day that he go out to the field and take care of the crops. Yeah. Right? Even when it's just a seed, even when it's in the ground, even when you can't see it, like he's still out there. You know what I mean? And man, that's the true path to growth, man.
Yeah.
All of these big overarching concepts and all. Yeah, I mean, like, concept is a beautiful, love is a beautiful concept, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. But just like patience and peace and all the other beautiful concepts, they have to be fleshed out moment by moment,
right?
Right? Like, you can't say I have peace. You got to have peace in every individual moment, mm-hmm. right? It has to be cultivated. It has to be grown. So, man, this might, I mean, I'm not even going to look at the time this time, but it feels like we've had a quicker podcast, right?
Yeah.
I'm actually comfortable with the amount of information that we shared. Y'all fellas have anything that y'all want to close with or that you want to end with?
I was just keep reinforcing the same thing, man. Just continue to practice that mindfulness, man, that, and being aware. Being aware of your surroundings, situations that you're in, emotions that you get, and just start trying to control them, man, and move past them. You know, don't let them take control over you, over your day, over your month, year, nothing, man. I mean, like you said, it's easier said than done.
Right.
But if you have that discipline, if you really desire to, you know, see a change in your life, man, and have good things come to you. You gotta be consistent. Like you say, man, you gotta have that love. You gotta have that compassion. And get all of that hate. All of that hate, jealousy, and envy gotta get out your heart, man. And you will feel the difference.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Physically, you will feel it. Mentally, you will feel it, man. And, man, it's a great feeling.
I think that's the meaning of cash your, you know, man, all up in that Bible today. But, you know, the man said, cast your burdens on me.
Yeah.
Like, those are your burdens. Your anger, your fear, your jealousy, your envy, your worry, your doubt. Those are your burdens.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, don't cast your rent on him. Cast your worry about your rent. You know what I mean? Like, that's what he wants you to cast.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Cast your envy about somebody else. Paying their rent.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever it may be, cast that. That's what he wants you to cast on. Big Jarvis, man. We closing up. What you got?
This is pretty much what Travis said, man. Just be mindful and awareness of situations and what's going on, man. Just grow and learn from it, man. Like I say, for example, like the situation I brought up about, you know, old guy talking about girl. Just analyze that situation. Like, for example, as I sit here, I analyze it. I'm saying, well, dang, he talked to her because he probably was more assertive. So, like, just use that and say, well, I could be more assertive in my life. I can grow from that situation and that experience and, you know, to be a better person, to be more assertive in my life, in your life or my life, for example. The other example that I brought up about, you know, the person having a better job than me, well, you know, he probably got that better job because, you know, he, you know, networked better than me. He built bridges instead of burned bridges, you know. Just use that for example. But yeah, just like I said, just use every situation and change from it and just be a better person.
So you can grow with anything, man. You can grow with color. You can grow with anything. And I'm piggybacking off what you said, different angle, man. Love yourself throughout everything, mm-hmm. right? Through perceived failures, through perceived downfalls, through perceived victories, through whatever it may be, always love yourself, man. Because like we said, man, it says love others as you love yourself. Like if you don't have no love for yourself, you cannot then love others, right? So if you give yourself grace and mercy, right, and you love yourself and you pick yourself up when you down, right, if you don't beat yourself up, then you then won't beat others up. So love yourself, man. As always, subscribe, share, comment. Yes. I tell you, man, we're getting some traction in the conversation area, right? Yeah, like, we started getting some real good feedback, comments. The website is up now.
Yeah, man. Make sure y'all go check out that website. It's www.whatifsav.com. Make sure y'all go check that out, man.
Right. And I am back in the tutoring arena. I'm back with Trav at this point. I'm sure at some point Jarvis will come aboard, but definitely back in the tutoring arena. We're on the math, the English, the Spanish, and the SAT. Yeah. Right now, nothing in the science and nothing in the history unless it was something like chemistry. Mm-hmm. This is just my understanding of history and science is basically about studying and memorizing the facts. And I know that chemistry and physics and things like that are different, and actually we will offer assistance in those areas, but as far as what a proton and a neutron is,
go back real quick. I don't want to get in trouble, man. I know you said we're gonna be doing tutoring, CJ and myself, and I can't forget about my wife.
Oh yeah. Okay.
I don't want to get in trouble. Can't forget about my wife.
I don't want you to get in trouble. and I'll be real, when I was thinking about the chemistry and the biology, I was thinking about my wife.
I thought you were getting ready to say it too. That's
what I was going to get down with the chemistry. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But the tutoring has definitely taken off, right? I actually did a tutor session before I came here.
Right.
So all the information is on whatifsav.com. Of course, the Facebook page, the YouTube channel. Man, we're reachable, man. Yes. Like I said, man, we want to talk with you. And you know, my father calls me after he listens to these podcasts, and we get into some good dialogue. That's what I would call it. You know what I'm saying? But I love to spar.
Yeah.
Right, and if you disagree, I want to talk about it, because at the end of the day, when my father and I hang up the phone, man, it's nothing but respect, and we have both reached our understanding.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a beautiful thing, man. Hey, I'm good if y'all are good. We done?
Yeah.
Hey, man, we out. Thank you for checking us out. This is the What If Podcast, where possibility begins.
And I'm gonna shine, homie, until my heart stops. Go ahead, envy me. I'm Raps MVP, and I ain't going nowhere, so you can get to know me.